one day you passed by me. You saw chains in my hands, and I saw with my eyes tears for me in your eyes. One day I passed by you, I saw my chains in your hands. I'm free because of you. Then the tears filled my eyes. How much, Lord, did you pay to set me free? I asked you, oh Lord, accept that my son is not too much for you. One day by me you'll pass, but my freedom you'll ask. Feeling my slavery, although in you I'm free, my troubles have bound me. Loving the thin world around me, I seek my place in it. That I'm yours, I forget.
Beautiful song, isn't it? All right. Thank you, Uncle, so much for singing with us. We are so blessed today to have such a wonderful guest speaker. And also, I would like to take this opportunity for you guys to ask any questions, of course, if Uncle doesn't mind.
Uncle, you told us earlier that serving is not optional. And I don't get it because servants are telling us that we have a free will. And if you can please elaborate about that. I'm serious, I don't get it.
Oh, I know you are. This just reminds me of a very interesting story. A story that will hopefully tell you why I said that. Turn up the volume, pump up the bass. To the slamming sounds of DJ Pulse Driver.
So, God's will is it's He knows it's the best thing for us. He knows exactly what's good for us, or like what we need, which is why we should like never doubt Him, or like doubt His will, which is which is why like we should trust in Him. Do you guys know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, no, definitely, for sure.
Definitely. I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, let me give you like a different example. Like, for example,
oh my god, this guy can't say one sentence without stuttering.
Wait, Michelle, what'd you say? What's
that
funny?
I really like your lesson, it's really good.
Yeah, that's for sure.
I don't get this. Why is he giving the lesson? He stinks. Worse than Erica and Nieder.
I know, and at least her lessons make sense. Hey guys, how are you all doing?
Good.
Good, good. I know you guys are well into the school year, and it's safe to say that you've all had your fair share of bad days, correct?
Yeah.
9 times out of 10, you guys don't really handle these days the way you should, and that's probably because we don't always see God's plan. I also think it's safe to say that Joseph was having a particularly bad day the day his brothers threw him into a well. And he had every right to be angry with them because his brothers are the people who are supposed to want to support his life, but they're the ones who wanted his death. Mm-hmm. But because God was there for him and he trusted in God's plan, he wasn't angry when his brothers threw him into a well. He wasn't angry when they sold him as a slave into a foreign country that he knew zero about. And because he knew that God was there for him, he was able to look sin in the eyes as it looked back at him through the eyes of a woman. And trusting in God's plan ultimately made him the ruler of the greatest nation of his time. Joseph didn't try to look for a plan B because plan A was God's plan, and that's a plan that never fails.
Please, no side conversations. We're almost done. 5 minutes.
5 minutes, too late.
They always make fun of me, and they keep on disrespecting me. And, you know, I try to prepare fun lessons for them and make it as interesting as possible for them, and they still don't listen. And sometimes they even bring up Erica and how great of a servant she is and how fun her lessons are, and I can't do anything about that. And, you know I love them, and I want them to see God, and I want to see God in them. But I don't know how to do that if they're always making fun of me and disrespecting me.
Yeah. I think there are some techniques that we can get you some help with for how to manage the class and control the classroom. But we can talk about that another time. Let me ask you this. Have you and Erica brought Christ to your classroom today?
I don't know. All I know is that they like her lessons more than mine.
We don't want to reduce your service to just the lesson. Lessons are important. But remember what we have talked about in the servant meeting the other day, that our job in the service, in any ministry, not to bring people to Christ, but to bring Christ to people.
How am I supposed to do that?
So, when we are serving, we are deacons. You know, deacons or diakonia in English means being a servant. And being a servant is like being like John the Baptist. He's pointing to Christ so people can follow him. And you enjoy the presence of God during your service. So there's one common factor that has to exist in every service to be successful.
And that is...
You want to know everything, huh? This one you're going to find out yourself. The one thing that you remember now, that when you come to the service, you enjoy being with God in the service, you enjoy the Word of God, the prayer, talking about God, talking about His heart, His grace, His compassion to us. If you do all this, you enjoy it, that's sufficient for now. Okay? Oh, I gotta go now, but let's continue the discussion. And we'll get you some help with the classroom, and continue to think about this stuff and pray about it, and God will help. You love God, Josh, and God will support you, and He will be with you. He always does. Okay?
I really need somebody to talk to, Karen. I can't live like this anymore. I hate being this depressed.
Julie, why are you saying that? I'm here for you. Plus, he's the one who lost you, not the other way around. You'll find him so much better than him.
Well, here's the thing.
I love and trust you, but I really need to talk to somebody who has understood the situation and can still give me good advice.
Yeah. Wait, why don't you talk to Erica about it?
The Sunday school servant tempted Erica?
Yeah, I bet she can relate. She's not that old anyway.
I don't know.
Well, wait, why don't you just call her? Okay, here, I'll send you her number, and you just give her a call.
Lord, help me understand what you want me to do to reach these kids' hearts. I know I'm not the best public speaker. I know my lessons aren't the best. And I know I have a lot of things wrong with me, but you know I'm trying, and you know how hard I'm trying. I'm trying my best for you, God.
I'm sorry, Josh! I'm sorry! Josh, please stop!
Josh, my son, is making a very slow progress in speech therapy. His frustration makes him violent sometimes, gets very worked up, and hits the bullies.
You can work through me to help me help those kids know you better, just like I did. I love you, Lord, just as you loved me first. Help me show those kids that love, so they can become closer to you, and so I can bring them to you.
Look, Julia, I'm sorry, but I can't deal with this right now. I'm extremely busy these days. I hope you understand that. You know what? There are other servants you can talk to. I'll give you their numbers. Again, I'm sorry. I don't have the time for this right now. Yeah, I get that you need someone to talk to. That's why I'm giving you another servant's number.
You're okay. Oh, thank God.
Hope you're doing well, sir. Glad to have you back. Just
yes.
Please don't move right now. You're in a very
yes.
dangerous condition.
Yes, I can't lose you now. I can't lose him. I can't.
Who is she?
Josh, I don't think that'll work with them.
I mean, what else do you suggest? I've tried everything. I've tried planning events for them. I've tried, you know, making outings for them. And they just don't show up to any of it.
You said you want to be their friend, right?
Yeah, I mean, I love them. But every time I try connecting with them or getting any closer to them, they just push me further away.
Well, do you remember when we crashed parties when we were younger?
Yeah.
How about we do that? We meet up with them. We hang out with them.
If you say so.
Josh, come on, be a little positive. We have God on our side. What can't we do?
You're right. Let's do it.
Let's go.
It appears that your son does not remember anything before the trauma occurred. He has retrograde amnesia, which means he lost his memory indefinitely.
What does this mean? Will his memory come back to him?
It's hard to tell. In some cases, the memories do return. In other cases, unfortunately, they don't.
Is there a timeline when his memory is supposed to come back to him?
There isn't a set time frame for the memories to return, but if they do, they'll return naturally. But for the sake of your son, let's not give him any false hope. He was severely injured.
You can go to your son now. We'll update you on his condition. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Ma'am, one more thing.
Dude, you're too good out there, man. Take it easy on me, man.
Hey, I was taking it easy on you, but...
Oh, really? Oh, so you're making fun of me now,
okay,
huh?
Okay, bye, man.
You're making fun of me.
It takes time. It's not that easy. But when God sees your determination and faithfulness, when God sees that you have a will to change, then He'll interfere and help you. Tell you what, think about it this way. Every time you hate them or feel angry, think about how to win them, how to get them on your side.
Yeah, I talked to her, but she said she was busy. I mean, I guess she seemed like she wanted the best for me, but whatever.
Well, what do you mean? Didn't you want to talk to someone about it?
Yeah, but I was hesitant to approach Erica in the first place. I'm not going through that embarrassment again.
Okay, I probably shouldn't say this, but I feel like your state is getting worse every day, so I really feel like you should talk to someone about it.
Move on, Karen. We're done with the subject. I'm just not going to talk to anyone.
Hey, guys, I need you to reach out to someone. I just heard they were in a car accident.
Who is it?
His name is Tony. Tony Enoch.
I'm not familiar with the Tony. Is he part of the youth?
Not that I know.
Yeah, he is. He passed through some rough times, and his dad passed away when he was young. His mom has medical issues. I think he has a sister, too.
Do you know him personally?
No, I don't. He was quiet when he was young, and when he didn't get the right attention, he stopped coming.
If he doesn't come regularly, how do we reach him? Do you have his contact information?
Yeah, we have his mother's info.
Ah, sounds great.
All right, I will leave this to you guys. Let me know how it goes, okay? All right, bye.
Take care, we'll catch up with you later.
So, what's the plan?
What plan?
What are we gonna do about this Tony kid?
What?
What are you laughing at? I'm serious.
Josh, you're kidding, right? We don't have his contact information, he doesn't come to church, and the only person we can get to him through is his mother, who just so happens to be exhausted and overworked, trying to provide for him and his sister while he ruins his life. Yeah. At this point, we just pray.
We can't just give up. We have to do something about it.
We? I wish you the best of luck with this on your own. I have more important things to take care of.
Excuse me. Okay. Do you guys know someone named Tony that used to go to our church?
A bit random, to be honest. I don't really think so.
Yeah, I don't think I know anybody with that name.
Sure the person you're looking for, his name is Tony?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure.
I don't know, I feel like we had someone with us a long time ago with that name.
Yeah. He used to come to our church a lot, like a bit ago. Tony Enoch, I think? Do you guys still talk to him at all or something? Or?
I barely even remember him. I don't think we'll talk when he came regularly.
If you guys know anything about him or something, just please let me know.
Touchdown, let's go!
Dude, oh my god, just chill. I almost spilled my drink because we were screaming.
Dude, passion can always be a good thing. It's a very good thing.
Yeah, dude, football's life.
Hi, Magda, how are you?
Good, how are you? Good to see you.
You too. How's Tony?
Tony's doing all right. His memory hasn't come back yet, and so unfortunately he doesn't remember anything from that night. He's doing well. He lost his phone, so all his contacts are gone too, so he can't remember those even.
I'm so sorry to hear that. I have a great idea. Why don't we try to take him out, try to get him some fresh air?
See, I tried that, but he doesn't want to get out. He won't listen to anyone.
Maybe if we can go try to convince him, try to stay positive for him.
I'm trying, believe me, but you're more than welcome to try.
Okay, I'll give it a try. Let's go.
Okay, let's go.
Hey, we're all going out. You down? Come on, it'll be fun. We even have family friends coming with us. We're all waiting for you downstairs.
I'm not feeling it. You guys can go.
Why don't you want to come, Tony?
Look, I don't know if I knew him before. I don't remember anything. I don't remember we were friends. You can go with your friends. You can have fun. All right, enjoy yourselves. I'm gonna stay here.
It's not like I came here for no reason, Tony. I mean, yeah, we never talked before, but I still want us to be friends. And it's not like we showed up to a random house. It'll be fun, come on.
If you didn't know me, why do you want to hang out?
Because I want us to be friends. I want to get to know you. I mean, it's totally your choice, but I really hope you can hang out today.
All right. Wait for me downstairs. I'll change. I'll come.
All right. Great. Let's go.
I was just kidding. Come on, don't take what I said too seriously.
Pretty hard not to, considering you insulted me and made me feel like crap.
Look, I was in a bad mood. You can't blame a guy for having a bad day.
This is not the first time, Mark, and you know it.
Can't you just let it go?
You disrespect me every time, and you want me to forgive you every time. I'm not interested in games, Mark. I was in this because I saw potential in you. Certainly not anymore.
Really? That's how you see it? Good. You don't deserve me. I can literally get 10 of you without trying. Good luck getting someone who is capable of handling your personality, kid.
Hey, it's okay. It's not your fault. He wasn't the right person for you. It's a sign. And you're still young. God has a plan for you. God has a plan for you and you're still young. It's not your fault.
But he said my personality.
It doesn't matter what he said. You're the daughter of the king. Look at me. Look at me. You're still young and you still have a bright future ahead of you. It's gonna be okay. Now, how about you say we go get something to eat? Ice cream? Okay.
Sounds like fun. Do you want to come with us, Irini?
No, thank you. My mom's on her way.
Are you sure? I could drive you home.
No, thank you. She's almost here.
All right. All right, well, I'll see you tomorrow. You say hi to Mom and Tony for me, okay?
All right, no problem.
What did you say your last name was again?
Enoch.
And your brother's name is Tony?
Yeah, what's wrong?
Nothing.
Is everything okay, Josh?
Yeah, do you mind waiting here with Rebecca while I talk to your mom?
Yeah, sure.
What was that all about? I have no idea.
Oh, Father, my Lord and Savior, help me serve you with all my heart, Lord. I know I'm not qualified to serve your children, but I'm trying my best, Lord. Please give me power, give me strength, give me wisdom, give me patience, Lord. Touch my heart and the children's hearts. They need you. Open their eyes so they can see what you do for them. Show them the beauty of your love. Lord, be with me always and give me the right words to say. I'm your servant. Guide me and help me. I talked to his mom and she said we're welcome to go anytime in the next week.
Sorry, Josh. I'm really busy the next couple of weeks. I don't think I can drive that far.
You're sure you can't go at any time? This kid really needs it.
I would love to, honestly. If my schedule clears up, I'll update you. My bad on this
one. Okay. Pray for me. I'll see you later. Might as well just go now.
What are you doing here?
Me? What are you doing here?
Don't get the wrong idea. I'm just here for a friend that needs help.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he kind of lost all his friends after the incident.
Lost his friends? What does that mean?
Well, he doesn't really like to talk about it, but he can't remember anything before the accident. Like, he can remember general world information, but that's about it.
General information? What does that even mean?
Like, you know, the stuff he learned, like, in school when he was younger.
So, did he or did he not lose his memory?
He did, but, like, he knows that 2 plus 2 equals 4, you know?
Okay, that makes sense.
Can I go now, Your Majesty?
Yes, you can go. Bye.
Bye.
So, Harvard, reaching for the stars, huh? You know, as long as you study and work hard, will be very successful.
Yeah, I try my best.
You know, though, what will help you with the success?
Studying harder?
Yeah, but there's something else. Let me put it to you this way. Who already knows your future?
God, I should pray about it, right?
Right. So as long as you let him in your life, and if everything else in life fails you, he'll always be there for you. You just have to let him in, right? So what are we gonna do about your future?
I'm gonna pray about it.
Exactly. Hey, man of the hour. How are you, bro?
Good, good. I don't know if you knew me from before, but I apologize if you did. I don't remember anything from my past.
No worries, man. I just wanted to stop by, see if you wanted to hang out. Be a fun time.
Irini, can you excuse us for a moment, please?
Sure.
Why do you want to hang out, man? You don't look my age, not even close to it, and I doubt you knew me.
To be honest, I have a message for you.
A message?
We have a friend who, he loves you very much, and he wanted me to tell you that both you guys should get closer.
He knew me? Like, you do know I got in a car accident, right?
Yeah, I know, and he knows too.
I lost my memory.
Yeah.
He knows that?
Yeah.
Who is he?
You'll have to come with me to find out. Probably tired of losing all day.
You're cheating, man.
Right,
you're
right,
cheating.
Right, right. All right, man. I gotta go. See you later, bud.
Yeah, see you. Thank you, Josh.
Hey, no problem. And if you ever hang out or if you ever want someone to talk to, you got my number.
Will do. Thank you.
gonna go get a burger. Do you want something? Or?
No, it's all right. I'll pass.
Okay.
You can go.
Are you gonna come in?
I'll wait for you. I'll wait for you. Hey, quick.
Yeah.
Just a birthmark. That's what I was told.
Birthmark? I thought we're closer friends than that.
I'm serious. Like, why? This is a birthmark. Honestly, I was born with these.
How can that be a birthmark? I know how people get those. I could have helped you. Just so you know, I don't appreciate being lied to. Yes, Tony?
What are these?
Look, son, I told you before.
What are these? Don't lie to me.
I'm really sorry to inform you about this under these circumstances, but we found scars on your son's arm.
Scars? What do you mean scars? What kind of scars are you talking?
At this point, it's mostly assumptions, but we can infer that your son used to self-harm.
No.
I'm sorry, I had to let you know. Because if he can't remember anything, it means he won't remember what he used to do to himself. As bad as it sounds, losing his memory could have been the only way he would have stopped what he was doing. We also found alcohol, marijuana, and even cocaine in his system. I know this is a lot to take in, but him not knowing about his past is probably the best for him.
No. Tony, I was trying to protect you.
You lied to me.
I didn't mean to lie to you.
No need. I'm going to my room.
What? Listen! I'm trying to help you, to protect you.
You lied to me, right to my face. Stop. I am going to my room.
Dear,
we're done.
Let me explain. Let me just explain it to you.
You lied once. You'll do it again. I don't trust what you're saying anymore. We're done. Stop.
Hey Josh, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good.
How are your Sunday school kids?
They're okay. They drive me crazy, but yeah, it's normal. I really enjoyed your lesson.
lesson today.
Thank you. I hope you can apply it to your life.
Yeah, no, it was really good. How long did it take you to prepare?
3 minutes.
Erica!
Yeah.
How are you?
Hey. Good to see you.
Hey.
Mar.
Oh,
how are you?
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
How's everything going?
It's going.
How's Tony?
Not gonna lie, we got into a fight earlier.
Why? What happened?
He lied to me and I told him I didn't appreciate it.
You know, everybody makes mistakes. Don't let something small like that get in between you guys.
That's the thing, it's not a small thing. He lied to me about his scars and he thought I was stupid enough to not know what they were actually from.
Wait. What scars?
Oh, he has scars on his wrist.
And what did you tell him?
Like I told you earlier, that I didn't appreciate being lied to.
And what did he say?
Nothing. He looked at me as if he was confused.
When did this all happen?
Like, I don't know, 3-4 days ago?
I'm gonna go now.
Why? Where are you going?
To this kid's place.
This kid? What kid? He's like 21. He doesn't need a babysitter.
No, I know. I just want to check up on him is all.
He's not gonna listen to you if he's come to apologize, Josh.
And why would I tell him to apologize?
Because he lied to her?
No, he didn't.
What?
I'm telling you, he didn't lie.
How do you know?
Look, I don't know. I'm just trying to give him the benefit of the doubt.
Josh, we both know how you get scars. Those aren't birthmarks.
Yeah, he didn't know, okay?
Wait, no. Where are you going?
Look, if you want an explanation, come with me and I'll give you an explanation on our way there. Other than that, I've waited long enough, okay?
Okay.
I'll be in the car.
Come in.
Hey, someone's on the phone for you.
Well, I'm not available.
He said it's urgent and he needs to talk to you.
I'm not in a mood to talk, so tell him I'm not gonna talk. What does he want anyway?
He said he knows you and he knows your full name.
He knows
you
me?
You guys hung out often.
He said he knows me?
Yeah.
All right, I'll come. Give me a second. Hello.
Hey, what's up, bro? How's life? Long time no talk.
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good.
You haven't answered my calls. Bro, what's up with that?
Let's just say I got in a car accident, and that's why I wasn't answering your calls.
That's unfortunate. Do you want to hang out?
Look, man. You probably don't notice, obviously, so I'll tell you, my car accident wasn't just a normal one. I kind of lost my memory, so.
Yeah, I know. They told me.
Who's they?
You know. Let's just go out and hang out, man.
Yeah. Let's do it. All right, I'll be there.
Tony, are you going out somewhere?
Yeah, I'm going out.
With who, though?
Going out with Robert.
Robert? Not Mary? Not Josh? Robert?
Here we go again. What's wrong with Robert? You were fine with me going out 5 seconds ago.
I love you. Mary loves you. Josh loves you, but Robert?
What's wrong with him?
He's from your past.
I'm not 15. I am 21.
I'm just trying to look out for you.
Thanks. No thanks. I can take care of myself. We're done.
Tony, don't go.
Get out of my way.
Don't go, Tony.
Get out of my way.
Tony, don't go.
You don't ever touch me. Ever.
Tony! What's up, man?
Josh!
How are you, bud? How are you?
I'm good. I'm sorry, though. I'm late, so I have to go.
What's the hurry? Where are you going?
I have somebody that can tell me, that knows my past, so I'm gonna go catch up with
him. Why are you going to meet him?
And you are?
Erica, church servant. Nice to meet you, Mr. Enoch.
Mr. Enoch? Who's she?
She's with me.
So why are you going to meet him?
Because he knows my past, and I don't remember my past, so he's gonna tell me my past.
What would you want to know about your past?
What?
Look, you need to move on. Everything happens for a reason. God allowed you to lose your memory, so maybe it's better for you that you don't know anything about your past. Okay? Tony, you don't have anything to worry about. God has a plan for you. Just think of Joseph. His brothers threw him into a well, and he was sent to a foreign country, but because he had faith in God and he trusted in him, he made him the ruler of the greatest nation of his time. I think you'll be fine.
You sure she's with you?
Yeah, I mean, maybe she has a point, man.
See you, bro. I gotta go. Next time when you come, don't bring Shakespearean clowns with you.
I don't like it. Where are you going? Did he really have to say that? I was just trying to help.
Don't take it personally. He's just not a fan of, you know, long sermons and whatnot.
I just don't see how finding out about his past is going to be positive in any way.
Look, it is what it is, all right? We just have to pray for him, and you know that God won't leave him, okay?
You're right.
What's up, dude? What's up, man? What's up, bro? Let me see. What's up, Robert? How's the ladies, man?
What?
You don't remember? Dude, you hooked up with all the girls, bro.
I didn't know I did all the girls, but...
What's wrong?
I mean... As I told you again, I don't remember anything, so I was hoping you might fill me in.
What do you want to know?
What was that like?
You're kind of like the leader of the crew, of our squad.
Okay, what did we do as a squad?
We did everything.
What does... you're gonna be more specific, man. What does everything mean?
Like party and stuff.
Again, how can I say this? That doesn't tell me anything. What did we do at parties?
You really want to know right now, right here.
Yeah, as long as we didn't kill anybody. Go ahead.
We kind of did like everything. I don't like heroin, alcohol, and weed, obviously.
Did we do anything else?
Yeah, be more specific. I don't know. What do you want to know exactly?
What about this?
What's happened? What's in the?
It's none of your business. If I were you, I'd go back to my party.
Go back to
the party?
Who's talking?
I don't know. I see someone.
Yeah. Yo, what's up? Come in.
Robert. I thought you had business to take care of. What are you doing here?
Oh, this is my business.
You can come and join me if you want.
This is the sign of our bond.
And the rest is history. That's what those marks are. Wow. I didn't see that coming. The big Tony's heavenly regrets. Didn't see that one coming. Whatever, man. I asked for this. I wanted to know the truth, and I got it, I guess. All right, I gotta go. I'm good. It's getting late.
Well, can I have your phone number, please?
Yeah, whatever.
Yo, what's up, Josh?
Hey, Tony, just wanted to check up on you, man. How's everything going?
Yeah, everything is good with me. Everything cool with you?
Yeah, everything's cool. Look, I honestly don't think you should meet with those people from your past, you know? I didn't talk to you about it today because you seem to be in a bad mood already, you know? I just don't think meeting up with them is going to do you any good. Don't take this the wrong way. You're like a brother to me. I just want you to be okay, you know?
Hey, look, you have nothing to worry about. It was just a one-time thing. I won't meet them again. Don't worry.
Promise?
Promise. Promise. Don't worry.
All right, just wanted to check on you, man.
All right. Look, I gotta go. I'm driving, and it's bad weather. It's raining, and it's pretty bad. So, I'll talk to you later, all right?
Love you, bro. And you know who else does?
Yep, you told me before. God loves me.
Well, you're finally home.
Good to see you too, Mom.
Why are you back so late?
Look, if you want to fight, we can fight any other day, okay? Just not today. I'm not in the mood, alright? We'll talk tomorrow.
Yes, today!
We'll talk tomorrow.
This is not a hotel. You don't get to go in and out as you please.
Mom,
when I say be home by 11, be
21.
Home by 11.
You need to get this through your head. I am 21, alright? We'll talk tomorrow.
No, we'll talk right now.
Stop talking, alright? You're pissing me off. I told you I'm not in a good mood. And you keep talking. Now get out of my face before I do something I regret. What's wrong? What happened?
Mom.
What's wrong? Where's she?
She fell in the kitchen.
Oh, God.
Hello, 911? Yeah, my mother fell and she's unconscious.
Mom. Mom, stay with me. Stay with me. Stay with me. Please, Mom. 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 You gotta stay with me. Mom. Mom. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. Please, stay with me. God, please. Mom. We're gonna get help, okay? Please. I'm so sorry. I am so sorry. Please, stay with me. Please. God, please.
Who is this?
It's me, bro. It's Robert. We gotta meet up.
Not now, bro. I am... Let's just say some things happened and I am not in the mood. So... Not gonna happen, no.
This is not an option, man. Do you care about yourself and your family?
Yeah.
Then you're gonna come to the Amimi at...
What? Yeah, I know where that is. Why?
I'll tell you when we get there.
Hi, Irini.
Hi, Uncle.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm good. How have you been?
I'm good.
It's gonna be okay.
I miss her.
I know you do. She's still with us right now. And she'll always be looking down on you and... You know, every time you do something great, she's gonna go to the saint next to her and say, "That's my daughter," right? Is your brother home?
Yeah, he's outside.
Could you leave us alone for a minute?
Sure.
Hey, Tony. How are you? Look, man, I know it's hard, and, you know, everything's gonna be okay, man. You know, God loves you, I love you, and I hate seeing you this way, man. You know, everything is going to be okay.
No, it's not.
What'd you say?
No, it's not gonna be okay.
Why would you say that?
Because you lied to me. God doesn't love me. At least not anymore. If he does, why would he allow this to happen? Why would he take away my mother? Why would he take away my mother? Why would he take my sister's mother? What did she do to deserve this? Why would he allow her to be an orphan?
She has you. And you know, if God didn't love you, you wouldn't be standing here today, you know? You wouldn't be alive. You wouldn't have survived that accident.
Stop with the lies. All of them. Stop. He doesn't love me.
Why do you keep saying that?
Because I killed her. I killed my mother. I knew she had a heart condition. And I still pushed her to the limit. I still disrespected her. And I still treated her like crap. I killed her. Even God doesn't love murderers.
It's not true. You know that. God will love you no matter...
Stop talking! Stop! I killed her. Do you know what's the last thing I told her? I told her to get out of my way. And I don't want to see her face again. That was the last thing she heard from me. All my fault.
It's all my fault, man.
It's okay, man. It'll be okay.
What took you so long?
Sorry, dude. Traffic was...
It's pretty bad.
I need to talk to you about something that I never really got the chance to because of all your questions about your past and stuff.
Make it quick. I'm not in a good mood. I told you this before.
Dude, we really messed up, dude. We messed up bad.
Who's we? What are you talking about?
Do you not remember anything about the night of the accident?
My accident? The car crash I was in?
Yeah, the night of the... Yeah, that night.
No, I don't remember. I told you, I forgot everything.
Alright, look, I'm gonna try to make this short and quick.
Please do. I'm not in a mood to talk.
So me, you, and Harry, we got into a fight with Mikey, our partner, and his crew.
Mikey? You told me about Harry before. Who's Mikey?
He was our dealer. He cheated on us and sold us fake cocaine.
We did cocaine?
No, we didn't. We were just dealing cocaine. That's where we got the cash to buy the other stuff that we got high off. Until Mikey cheated us $3,000. So we faced him and told him that we want our money back. But he wouldn't give us a dime. He told us that too. So we had to do something. And that's where we began. To the slam it sounds of DJ Pulse Driver. All three of us went to the party. We knew that the money would be stacked somewhere in Mikey's room upstairs. Someone was gonna have to go upstairs without anybody noticing and getting the money back from wherever he hid it. But that was almost impossible with the amount of people attending. There was only one way someone could go upstairs undetected. A distraction.
Calm down, everybody down, everybody. I would like to give, music down please. Thank you. I would like to give the biggest shout out to my boy right here, Mikey, for throwing this amazing party. Now who's ready to party? Let's go!
Yeah!
We agreed that you would stop the party by standing on a table and stop everybody from partying. You let them know you have something important to say. When everybody looks at you and Mikey realizes you're at his party, he and his boys will try to get you off the table.
Great story, man. Make it a movie.
I'm serious, man. That's what happened.
Even if it is, why should I care, dude? Why am I here? Why are you telling me this?
Just be patient. I'll get there. You hyped the party big time on that table, and everybody started going crazy. When you got off the table, Mikey's boys brought you to the side and told you that you need to leave. You flashed your famous smile and started leaving. Done with our task and waiting for you outside. Hey.
Harry had to go home with his car, so he left in his own car. And I came in your car. And then while we were driving home, the accident happened.
You're telling me you were with me on the night of the accident? How?
Yeah, I was. I don't have a reason to lie.
It makes no sense, man. You're lying.
Wait, I got it. Here. This is the cross. I think your sister gave it to you or something as a present. It has your blood from that night.
But even if I was there and you were there, they would have told me later on that someone was with me in the car.
I was, but then I woke up and I saw you in blood and stuff. So I and we had marijuana and coke in the back. And the 20 grand that we had, that we stole from Mikey. So I took the money and left.
20 grand? You just said you stole 3,000. How did that become 20?
Yeah, me and Harry, when we went upstairs to get the money, we found a lot of money and we had to show him that for what he did for us, we had to make him pay. So we took 20 instead of 3.
This is starting to get on my nerves, so if there's a point to all this nonsense, get to it. I'm done.
So I saw we had those drugs and money in the back. I thought if we called the cops, we were gonna be charged with a lot of crap and probably arrested as well. So I took the money and the rest of the stuff. Called the cops to report that you were still in a bad condition and started walking home since I lived nearby.
I told you before, I am not in a mood for this. I do not want you to waste my time, and I do not get the reason you're telling me all of this.
Dude.
And you're still telling me all of this. I'm about to leave, man.
Mikey found out about the stolen money.
Yeah, who wouldn't notice 20 grand, $20,000 disappearing?
That wasn't the plan. We knew that he had a lot of cash stacked in his home, at his house. But we didn't know that he would notice, but he's been looking for who did it for 3 weeks. And guess who he remembered at the party at the night of the accident?
Me. Just give him his money back then.
I can't do that.
Please tell me you did not spend that money.
I didn't.
Oh, thank goodness. What's the problem then?
I lost the money.
What? You lost $20,000.
Can you lower your voice, please?
I'm lowering my voice. Explain, please.
At the night of the accident, I was kinda high. So I don't really remember anything other than what I told you right now. So the next day I woke up and the bag wasn't there.
Search for it, man. Search for it harder.
Dude, I did. I searched in the house. I searched everywhere. I can't find it.
Oh my God.
And Mikey said if I don't bring it by Friday, he will hurt people closest to us.
Friday? This Friday? Tomorrow? I can't even think, man. What am I supposed to do now? What are we gonna do?
I think you should go apologize to him.
What should I apologize for what?
He felt really disrespected when he went to his party that night and stole his money. Maybe if you go apologize to him, maybe he will give us one more day
to get the money.
I'm not coming, man. You want me to go to that guy? No, I'm not coming.
I can't go by myself. I'm not gonna go by myself.
Bro, okay. You don't want to go by yourself? Go ahead. That's fine. Go with that hairy guy you were talking about. Take him and go.
Dude, okay, hairy?
I am not coming. I have a sister to take care of. I'm not coming.
Dude, Harry overdosed. He's been in a coma for 3 weeks.
I'm not coming, man. It's not gonna happen.
Dude, you're our only chance. If you buy us one more day, we can do something. My uncle is coming tomorrow and I could get the money from him. But we just need one more day, please. We just need one more day, just come.
Hey, if you need anything, or I don't come back before sunset, you call Uncle Josh, okay?
Yeah, sure. Hi, Uncle. Sorry to bother you, but my brother's been acting a little weird, and I wanted to know if you knew why. Well, he came into my room and kissed me goodbye, and said if he doesn't come back before sunset, to call you. He has an iPhone. Okay. Bye.
What are you looking at? Where are we?
Dude, we're meeting Mikey here.
We're meeting Mikey here, the drug lord. In a neighborhood.
Yeah.
What?
Dude, we're in a neighborhood. Most likely, they're not gonna use their guns.
So we're in a neighborhood so they don't use their guns. You got a haircut too?
Yeah, dude, if I'm gonna die right now, I'm gonna go out in style.
Where's my money?
Look, man, I messed up, okay? I shouldn't have crashed your party. I shouldn't have been in there in the first place, okay? I shouldn't have stolen anything. I messed up, okay? But we're brothers, okay? And brothers fight, but they get along at the end, okay? So we're hoping that you will forgive us, all right?
Money first, then we talk.
We have your money, just in a locker downtown.
What's it doing downtown?
Well, when we first stole the money, we had to keep it safe. So we put it in that locker. If you give us one more day, we'll have your money. Oh my gosh.
What's wrong?
That's the bag that has the money.
That's your bag?
Yeah, dude, that's the bag. And by the way, we're about to die.
So first you disrespect me by saying I cheated the merchandise, then you crash my party, then you steal from my room. And are you both lying to my face, telling me the bag is downtown when it's right here?
Why did you lie, man?
Bro, I was trying to help.
Again, you're always coming in clutch. Always. I'm going to make you regret the day you even had a thought of messing with me. Especially you, Tony.
Yo, back up. Back up. Hey, come on. Oh!
Yo.
Josh, stay with me, man. Stay with me. Come on, stay with me. Stay with me, man. It's gonna be okay, man. It's gonna be okay. Don't worry about it, man. Don't worry about it. I can't lose you now, man. It's gonna be all right. Don't worry, okay? Please, stay. You're gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Tony, listen to me. You have to
serve Christ. Don't let him go, ever. Tony, I love you, Tony.
Stay with him. Come on, stay with him. It'll be okay. I'll be good. Don't worry, Josh. Please, stay with me. Stay. Josh!
We are here today to celebrate a life. Josh. I was told I should read off the paper, but I can't. I'm just gonna tell you my side of the story. I didn't listen. I was stubborn. I complained. And I ignored him every time. The person that loved me, I ignored. He stood next to me when I was down. He stood next to me and made me rise up and help me become the best person I've ever been. He believed in me. He believed I can become like him. I can become on his image. And what did I do in return? I disobeyed him. I didn't listen. What would a normal person do after that? Would he stand next to you? Would he help you? Josh wasn't just a normal person. He still loved me with all of his heart, to the point where he died for me. He died for me. For me. The person that disobeyed him and didn't listen to him and disrespected him. Over and over. For the first time, I actually saw God's love. When I looked at him, I saw God in him. I saw him through him. He gave up his life for me. The least I can do right now is be that person he wanted me to be. Be on his image. Live his life. Without him, I wouldn't be here. But because he loved me, I am here talking to you today. I owe him everything. I owe him my life. For the longest time, I didn't understand what Josh was telling me when he said, God loves me and you unconditionally.
I just didn't get it. And then I understood. What happened to me wasn't an accident. What happened to me was because God wanted me to know what he did for all of us. He came and he stood in front of a judge instead of me. He came and was tortured. He was tortured instead of me. He came and he died for me. He died for me. Because he loves me. And he loves you. He couldn't just stand around and see his sons and daughters perishing. Even though we disappoint him time after time again. He still loves us. Doesn't he deserve a thank you? He came and he gave us a new life. And we're gonna tell him, no thank you, we can't help your people, take care of your children. To answer your question, yes. Yes. To be Christian is to be a servant. I'm not saying you have to be a Sunday school teacher. But there's so many other ways we have to serve. By taking care of others. By being kind to others. By helping others. Most importantly, showing others. Showing others that same love he showed us on the cross. To be Christian is to be a servant. Be serving Christians.